Power can be positive or negative effect. It depends on the use of power, exactly as money. Money is a social construction, and here I'd rather talk very quickly through images about my thinking. As a social scientist, I think that is evident what I'm saying, but for some reason, this is never said on television, it's never said on newspaper, it's said by, you know, some of my friends, but it's said in this, you know, room. But what I think, we need to educate people that the use of power and the use of money has an effective or so this is not a good use of money. Money for financial gain. Money for detrimental effect. So how we structure our relationship with money. Here we have heard already how many brilliant minds have alternative of the current use. I want to propose to each of you in the room to use your power in promoting awareness that the use of money is functional or dysfunctional for society. So I want to put money and value. If money has to be for money, that's bad. If money has to be for construing a future that is available for everyone, these are examples of the structuring human and natural capital. So for example, I want cartoon for kids to educate them about the power and money. I want to suggest that some of you are entrepreneurs, some of you are gifted politicians, some of you are rich and contribute to charity. Why don't you, maybe in collaboration with our academy, create a yearly prize for young economists that teach about the use of money in a sustainable way? Why don't you finance the creation of an app that make people for free calculate their use of money if they're investing in a bank and bonds? In other words, my point is we need to facilitate a process where people, there are a lot of good people that are not aware, as Frank was rightly pointing out, that being good people is not enough to avoid damage. So my suggestion is here to ask you humbly, what can you do? How can you use your power and your money and be part of the solution and not the problem? Thank you.